Hello everyone, in this video, let us understand how to draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for an overhanging beam with a UDL. Many people find it difficult drawing shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for overhanging beam. But this is also quite simple if you understand the concept of drawing shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. In order to draw these diagrams, first thing we need to do is find the reaction forces. So where are the reactions in this? The reactions are at B, let us say this is RB, and at C, which is RC. Okay, then we need to find these reactions first. So how to find the reactions? Balance the forces. So which means upward forces is equal to downward forces. So downward forces is 10 kilonewton per meter. Let us say this is W is equal to 10 kilonewton per meter. So this is the downward force, and so total force will be 10 into this 2.5 plus 5 and plus 2.5, which is 10, which is 100 kilonewton. This is the total downward force. So what are the upward forces? RB and RC. So 100 is equal to RB plus RC. So this is a symmetric one. So RB will be equal to RC. RB is equal to RC. So RB is equal to 50 kilonewtons and RC is equal to 50 kilonewtons. So this is 50 kilonewton. This is also 50 kilonewtons. Now let us find the shear force diagram. So how to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram? Just divide the beam into different parts and then consider a section. So for example, from the right end, I am going to calculate shear forces and bending moments. So first consider this part C to D. So this is point C, this is D. Now I am considering a section at this point. So this is the section, and I am taking this section from a reference of this point. So this is X. From point D, I am taking the point D is a reference, and from that the section is moving here and there between C to D. So D is the reference point in this. So what is the load acting in C to D part? This is the UDL, 10 kilonewton per meter. This is the load acting. Now shear force, and let us say here bending moment. So what is the shear force at this section at a distance of X from D? That will be, let me clarify with the convention I use for shear force. The convention I use is, this is the section. For me, this is positive. If the forces are acting like this, this is negative. And also for bending moment, if the beam bends like this, then this is negative. If the beam bends like this, this is positive. So this is the sign convention I use. Now shear force. So this UDL produces positive shear force, as you can see this. So now W into X, this is the shear force in this C to D part. Now what is force at FC, shear force at C? which is equal to W into this section moves up to C. So this is distance 2.5 meter. So W into X is 2.5 meter. What is W? Which is 10 into 2.5, which is 25 kilonewton. Then what is the bending moment? And also, how the shear force line travels from D to C? You can see this equation W into X. This is a linear one. So 25 kilonewton at C, and how it is traveling? Linear. A straight inclined line is joining C and D. So next, bending moment. So what is the bending moment? This UDL is trying to bend in this way. So it will be a negative one. So minus W into X is the load, and into X by 2 gives us the bending moment due to this UDL. So minus W X square by 2. And what is bending moment at C? That will be minus 10 into what is the X? 2.5 square divided by 2. So the answer will be minus 31.25 kilonewton meter. So in case of shear force, it traveled in a linear path. In case of bending moment, you can see X square, there is a term X square, which means it is a parabolic path, and this value is 31.25, minus 31.25. So let us say this is minus 30.25, and how it is traveling from D to C. So from D to C, it is traveling a parabolic path. And also you need to see whether it can travel in a parabolic path in this way or else in this way. So how to find the correct path? I have made a video on this topic. I'll attach in the cards here, so you can watch that video and come back here if you don't know how to draw this. And also I'll make a new video on this topic. That video is the old one, so I'll make a new video on this. So now this will be in this way. This is the correct one. If you look into that video, you will be finding how to draw this shape of bending moment. Now, so this part is CD part is completed. Now let us come to BCD part. This is B. This is C. And this is D. So in this part, let us consider a section here. So what is the loading here? This is UDL, and also there is a reaction force RC, which is equal to 50 kilonewton. This is 10 kilonewton per meter. And from this section, from point D, this is the X distance. Okay, shear force, calculating the shear force in B to C. Shear force is equal to W into X. This is the shear force due to the UDL, and also there is a force 50 kilonewton RC. So that is minus 50. So 10 into what is this X? So this is calculating force at FB. So this total distance is 5 plus 2.5, which is equal to 7.5 meter. And also I forgot to draw the line here. So up to here shear force is 25 kilonewtons. And when it reaches C, there is RC, which is equal to 50 kilonewton. So that will be minus 50, and it will go way down to here. So this is 25, and this is also 25 kilonewton. So now at FB, it is 10 into the distance is 7.5 minus 50, which is equal to 75 minus 50, which is 25 kilonewtons. So 25 kilonewtons is at V. So this is 25 kilonewtons. Now this should travel from this point to this point. So joining a straight line, we will be getting this, and this is the midpoint of the beam. Now let us calculate the bending moment here. So in case of bending moment, it is minus W into x by 2, and bending moment due to this RC is equal to plus RC into what is the distance, x minus this distance x minus this is 2.5 meter. So x minus 2.5. So we will be getting this. This is also a parabolic form equation, which consists of x square. So now MB, so what is the bending moment at B, which is equal to minus 10 into x square by 2. X is the distance 7.5 square divided by 2, plus RC is 50, and X is 7.5 minus 2.5. So MB is equal to, let me calculate this, minus 10 to 7.5, which gives minus 31.25 kilonewton meter. So which is same as MC. MB is equal to MC. MB is equal to MC. This is also minus 31.25. So then you can join like this, but that is not correct because we got equation of parabola. So this is the term x square. So this is a parabolic one. How can you draw a straight line? So we need to draw the parabola. That means the two points can be joined like this, or joined like this, or it may be joined below the zero line. So it may be anything. So let us find the maximum bending moment will be at a point where the shear force is equal to zero. So let us take bending moment, let us find bending moment at the midpoint of the section, midpoint of the beam. So at midpoint means where is the midpoint? This will be the midpoint, and this will be 2.5 meters. Now M, let us say this is M mid, which is equal to minus 10 into, so the midpoint distance from D is, in this case this is the x, so that is 5 square by 2 plus 50 into, so what is the distance of RC from the midpoint? That is equal to 2.5, or you can say x minus 2.5. x is here 5 minus 2.5, which gives us a value which gives us 0 kilonewton meter. So that means we need to join to a midpoint. From this point to midpoint, a parabola form, and from this point to this point, it is a, again parabola. So again, from this in this section, let us find in AB. In this case, I will be considering the left part of the section. You can consider the right part of the section also, but this will be a long section because again here C will be present, here D will be present, so this will be a very long section. So for simplicity, you can consider the left part of the section. So this is the left part of the section, and this is the right part of the section. So what will be the load acting on this? The load acting is UDL on the left part of the section, only UDL. And what is the x from reference point from this A? This is x. Now let us calculate the shear force. Shear force is this is turning like this, that means it is a negative shear force, which is minus Wx. So what is the shear force at B? Shear force at B is equal to minus 10 into x is, this total distance is 2.5 meter. So 2.5, which gives us minus 25 kilonewton. So here it is 25 kilonewton at this point, and from this point it falls to here because there is a point load 50 kilonewton. So this is also 25 kilonewton. So from this point it is falling up to 25 kilonewton with a straight line. Why straight line? Why straight inclined line? Because W into X, this is the equation of a straight line. Now let us find the bending moment in section AB. So bending moment will be, this will be trying to bend the beam in this way. So this is a negative bending moment. That means minus W into X is the load, and X by 2 is the centroid distance, and so this is the only bending moment. So MB is equal to minus 10 into X square by 2. X is 2.5 square by 2, which gives us minus 31.25 kilonewton meter. So how should we join this? X square, this is a parabola. So same parabola repeats here. So this is how you need to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. And also I am remembering you once again that these should be drawn correctly, either concave up or concave down. That should be drawn correctly. Please watch that video I am attaching here, so you can get a clarity on this. So finally, this is 31.25 kilonewton meter, and this is also same.